10 months after leaving WH, Queen Michelle makes disturbing claim about what Secret Service did to her. And once again we have to listen to the former First Lady, Michelle Obama, whine about her 8 long years sponging off the already overburdened American taxpayer. In a recent interview she stated she is upset that in order to keep her safe, the Secret Service wouldn't let her open a window or walk out on her balcony alone while she lived in the White House. She also claimed that the former president, Barack Hussein Obama, doesn't have any friends and that she's extremely relieved to be out of the White House. Michelle, it's okay, really, we, the American people who don't suffer from acute white guilt like our liberal counterparts, also felt the exact same way when we saw you and Barry finally boarding that helicopter to leave the White House forever. Relief. And the fact that your husband, Barry, is a rabid narcissist might also be the reason he has no friends. The Obamas have spent over $44,351,777.12 in taxpayer cash on travel. The Obamas have spent over $44 million in taxpayer money on travel and vacations. Some are even calling him the most well-traveled, expensive president in our nation's history. As Americans head off for the long holiday weekend, let's take a look back at some of the president's holiday spending. Our president vacations a lot, we're talking $44,351,777.12 worth of a lot, with most expenses charged to the American taxpayer. As of March 2014, Obama has spent more time traveling internationally than any other president, taking 31 trips since assuming office in 2009. The 119 days spent overseas have cost taxpayers millions of dollars. At the same point in their respective presidencies, George W. Bush had spent 116 days on 28 trips, Bill Clinton had spent 113 days on 27 trips, and Ronald Reagan had spent 73 days on just 14 trips. In 2010, Obama flew aboard Air Force One 172 times, nearly every other day. Just the cost of flying aboard Air Force One to Obama's hometown of Chicago reportedly hovers around $180,000 per hour. In addition to all of his international travel, the president spends a significant amount of time traveling with his family. The Obama family has taken vacations to exclusive beaches in New England, private clubs in Key Largo and, of course, luxurious beaches in Hawaii. According to the government watchdog group Judicial Watch, beginning with the infamous New York date night, the Obamas have spent $44,351,777.12 in taxpayer cash on travel expenses. The actual total cost may be higher, as the White House is not subject to the Freedom of Information Act. Here we have a president that gets on the budget line by line, but this apparently doesn't apply to his travel, President of Judicial Watch, Tom Fitton, said in an interview with the Daily Caller. Frequently missing from the data are the costs of housing the first family and staff, costs of prepositioning the Secret Service and their equipment, and other travel expenses such as meals and beverages. We've got this financial crisis here in Washington, and the president and his family need to be more sensitive as to the cost concerned with his travel, Fitton said. We are especially concerned about the excessive luxury travel, such as his trip to Hawaii. In 2013 alone, President Obama incurred $7,396,531 in flight expenses for his family vacations to Hawaii and Martha's Vineyard, as well as a trip to California to appear on the Jay Leno show. The Obamas are abusing the public trust and the taxpayers with unnecessary luxurious vacations and travel, Fitton said in a press release. These staggering costs show why these documents were covered up and we had to sue in federal court to get them. Another transparency fail for the Obama gang. Zero. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. And once again we have to listen to the former First Lady, Michelle Obama, whine about her 8 long years sponging off the already overburdened American taxpayer. In a recent interview she stated she is upset that in order to keep her safe, the Secret Service wouldn't let her open a window or walk out on her balcony alone while she lived in the White House. She also claimed that the former president, Barack Hussein Obama, doesn't have any friends and that she's extremely relieved to be out of the White House. Michelle, it's okay, really, we, the American people who don't suffer from acute white guilt like our liberal counterparts, also felt the exact same way when we saw you and Barry finally boarding that helicopter to leave the White House forever. Relief. And the fact that your husband, Barry, is a rabid narcissist might also be the reason he has no friends. She hated being in the White House, but she did love those lavish vacations on our dime. That's for sure. The Daily Caller reports. The Obamas have spent over $44,351,777.12 in taxpayer cash on travel. The Obamas have spent over $44 million in taxpayer money on travel and vacations. Some are even calling him the most well-traveled, expensive president in our nation's history. As Americans head off for the long holiday weekend, let's take a look back at some of the president's holiday spending. Our president vacations a lot. We're talking $44,351,777.12 worth of a lot, with most expenses charged to the American taxpayer. As of March 2014, Obama has spent more time traveling internationally than any other president, taking 31 trips since assuming office in 2009. The 119 days spent overseas have cost taxpayers millions of dollars. At the same point in their respective presidencies, George W. Bush had spent 116 days on 28 trips, Bill Clinton had spent 113 days on 27 trips, and Ronald Reagan had spent 73 days on just 14 trips. In 2010, Obama flew aboard Air Force One 172 times, nearly every other day. Just the cost of flying aboard Air Force One to Obama's hometown of Chicago reportedly hovers around $180,000 per hour. In addition to all of his international travel, the president spends a significant amount of time traveling with his family. The Obama family has taken vacations to exclusive beaches in New England, private clubs in Key Largo, and, of course, luxurious beaches in Hawaii. According to the government watchdog group Judicial Watch, beginning with the infamous New York date night, the Obamas have spent $44,351,777.12 in taxpayer cash on travel expenses. The actual total cost may be higher, as the White House is not subject to the Freedom of Information Act. Here we have a president that gets on the budget line by line, but this apparently doesn't apply to his travel, president of Judicial Watch, Tom Fitton, said in an interview with the Daily Caller. Frequently missing from the data are the costs of housing the first family and staff, costs of prepositioning the Secret Service and their equipment, and other travel expenses such as meals and beverages. We've got this financial crisis here in Washington, and the president and his family need to be more sensitive as to the cost concerned with his travel, Fitton said. We are especially concerned about the excessive luxury travel, such as his trip to Hawaii. In 2013 alone, President Obama incurred $7,396,531 in flight expenses for his family vacations to Hawaii and Martha's Vineyard, as well as a trip to California to appear on the Jay Leno show. The Obamas are abusing the public trust and the taxpayers with unnecessary luxurious vacations and travel, Fitton said in a press release. These staggering costs show why these documents were covered up and we had to sue in federal court to get them. Another transparency fail for the Obama gang. It seems like it was so bad being the first lady that not even the total of $44,351,777.12 spent on vacations was enough to take the sting out of it for Michelle Obama. Not even the trip Michelle Obama, along with her daughters Sasha and Malia, took to Africa to waste taxpayer money in order to promote the former First Lady's Let Girls Learn initiative was enough. Nothing was ever enough for these people. Zero. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. And once again we have to listen to the former First Lady, Michelle Obama, whine about her 8 long years sponging off the already overburdened American taxpayer. In a recent interview, she stated she is upset that in order to keep her safe, the Secret Service wouldn't let her open a window or walk out on her balcony alone while she lived in the White House. She also claimed that the former president, Barack Hussein Obama, doesn't have any friends and that she's extremely relieved to be out of the White House. Michelle, it's okay, really, we, the American people who don't suffer from acute white guilt like our liberal counterparts, also felt the exact same way when we saw you and Barry finally boarding that helicopter to leave the White House forever. Relief. And the fact that your husband, Barry, is a rabid narcissist might also be the reason he has no friends. She hated being in the White House, but she didn't love those lavish vacations on our dime. That's for sure. The Daily Caller reports. The Obamas have spent over $44,351,777.12 in taxpayer cash on travel. The Obamas have spent over $44 million in taxpayer money on travel and vacations. Some are even calling him the most well-traveled, expensive president in our nation's history. As Americans head off for the long holiday weekend, let's take a look back at some of the president's holiday spending. Our president vacations a lot, we're talking $44,351,777.12 worth of a lot, with most expenses charged to the American taxpayer. As of March 2014, Obama has spent more time traveling internationally than any other president, taking 31 trips since assuming office in 2009. The 119 days spent overseas have cost taxpayers millions of dollars. At the same point in the